Today's keyword is mud. It can be used in phrases like mush is oil. It can also refer to charm, elegance, and stylishness. How many times can you hear it throughout the video? I like Korean fried chicken. I like fried chicken in general, especially the barbecue one. But Korean fried chicken is just amazing. I cannot say though that I've tried the real deal yet, because most of the options that I've had nearby are just reinterpretations of it. Very delicious though. So I thought I would come here to tell you a little bit more about it while I do some sketching to relax. Please ignore the cat, she's going to be around for the whole video. There are many ingredients I will point as characteristics of Korean fried chicken, like especially the potato starch. We don't have something similar in Mexican cuisine, and I think that's one clear difference for the crust, because the flour that we use here is mostly tasteless when it's cooked. So when you make wings, buns, or anything else, you either add condiments to the flour mix or add a sauce on top. I've cooked Korean pancakes with potato flour, and I have to admit that I cannot recognize the potato flavor in the Korean fried chicken. By the way, is there a short way of saying Korean fried chicken? I feel if I use the initials, it would just sound like the brand, so I would just call it KoFC. So the KoFC I've tried so far has only been the sweet type, because I like the sweet food. And the places I've gone to don't have the garlic type. The first one was crunchy and sweet, but not sweet enough that you will feel it was just plain sugar, or that your teeth will fall after one bite. That's funny about me, because I like sweet food, but not too sweet. My teeth literally hurt when something is too sweet. Anyway, it was presented in a plate, like elegantly sprinkled with onion, and a stylishly bathed in sauce. So much is oil. 멋있는 것 같아요. 따다고 냄새 정 미쳐서. I've been practicing my Korean. I was in a restaurant, so obviously the presentation was better. It was warm and crunchy, and everything else you expect in a restaurant. The second time I had KoFC was in a park food stall, and it was near the end of their selling hours. So the chicken wasn't as crunchy as the first place. It also wasn't as stylishly presented. And it wasn't that warm. It was a little soggy, but the texture wasn't bad. I also found interesting that the rice one flavor was very present. It was similar as to having vinegar all over it, but the taste wasn't overwhelming at all. It was present, but balanced, if that makes sense. The most shocking part is that I haven't been able to take the second one out of my head for weeks. It was a whole different experience. I haven't made KoFC myself for several reasons. Mostly because I don't have all of the ingredients, and I wanted to be as close as possible to the Korean recipe. If I do, I would probably go for garlic first. I'm dying to taste it. I will make like a little portion of garlic, and everything else will be sweet. I also wonder if I can make KoFC recipe with the way fried chicken is made in here, to have like a spice flour mix with the Korean sauce. It may be too many flavors, so I'll see. I haven't drawn in a while, but I thought I would be less nervous talking to you like this. Let me know in the comments if you've tried KoFC, and if you've seen differences in taste, or if you've tried making it yourself. Thank you for watching, see you next time. Because most of the options that I've had nearby are just reinterpretations.